DS18B20, the most popular temperature sensor among Arduino users. I use them a lot in my projects. What I did not expect is to find a fake sensor that actually works. Well, let me explain why your sensor might be fake and why you need to use the real one. Well, let's get started. Hi guys, welcome to Electrical Project channel. For those who knew, the DS18B20 is a digital temperature sensor. It uses just 3 wires, 2 for power and 1 for data. And the awesome part is, you can connect multiple sensors in parallel. And this is possible because each sensor has a unique address. And this allows to read temperature from each sensor independently, even though they connected to the same 3-wire bus. I have 5 of them. Inside, outside, in the attic, in the basement, and one measuring heating system temperature. As you can see, my network is pretty big, and in such big network a fake sensor can cause a lot of troubles. Well, first I want to show you that both sensors actually work. The real one works. And the fake one works as well, but don't be fooled. Now let me show you what happens when I do the same on my big network that has 5 sensors. Here on my phone you can see real-time data from all sensors. It updates every 2 seconds. Let's try the real one. And nothing happens, network works. Now let's try to connect the fake one. And everything stops working completely. After disconnecting, everything goes back to normal. Now let's see what's going on with sensors' addresses. Let's connect the real sensor first. And we see one more sensor detected. We see its address and temperature readings. Now let's try a fake one. No new address is detected, but other sensors start to show -127, which means an error. The fake sensor disrupts all communication on the bus. But that is not all. If I disconnect all distance sensors, it starts to work without errors. Now I only have 2 sensors connected, one that measures temperature inside and this fake sensor. So if you have a short bus, you may not even notice a fake sensor. But if I connect other sensors, I have only errors, no temperature readings at all. But even after all this, I couldn't fully believe that Chinese managed to fake a pretty complicated digital sensor. Previously I thought if it's fake, it will not work at all, but I was wrong. So after some research, I built a fake sensor tester, link to the code you can find in the description. It turns out that Chinese did not implement all features of the sensor. From the first lines of the datasheet, we can see that the sensor provides 9-bit to 12-bit resolution, and it is not true for the fake sensor. Also, it should have an alarm function with upper and lower trigger points. And it's also not true for the fake sensor. Also, we can see that depending on the resolution, we should have different temperature conversion time. And it's not true for the fake sensor. So here is my fake sensor tester. Here you can see that it sets different resolutions and then checks what resolution sensor currently using. The normal sensor should support 9, 10, 11, 12 bits resolution. Then tester writes arbitrary values in alarm trigger registers. On the line below we can see what we read from those registers. And the last line is time conversion. It depends on the resolution and should be close to what we have in the datasheet. Now let's connect the fake sensor and see what we get. First of all, the fake sensor doesn't support 9 and 10 bit resolution. And second, as you can see, it doesn't matter what we write to alarm registers, we always get 255. And the last inconsistency is the time conversion. The fake sensor is actually extremely fast. It requires only 35 milliseconds to do temperature conversion. The real sensor needs almost 600 milliseconds. So it is 17 times faster at 12-bit resolution, which is actually pretty damn good. With the real sensor you can get less than 2 readings per second. But with the fake you can get 28 readings per second at 12-bit resolution. It sounds pretty good, but actually it doesn't matter, because this Chinese crappy sensor is not precise. So, if you actually need speed, then it's better to use the original sensor at 9-bit resolution. You will get about 13 readings per second, but you can be sure about its accuracy. And what is even more important, you will get reliable communication, without errors. So, what about you guys? Have you ever got a fake sensor? Is your one-wire bus stable? Tell me about your experience. And that is all for today. Thanks for watching.